Hello students, in this video we are going to solve some more numerical examples on direct central impact. So it is example number 7, right? So let us read the statement. A bullet of mass 100 grams is fired into a freely suspended target of mass 10 kg. Due to impact, the bullet gets embedded in the target and the target with bullet moves with a velocity of 7 meters per second. So after impact, the target along with the bullet moves together. Bullet is embedded inside the target and both are moving together after impact. So this is which type of impact? Plastic impact, right? So find the velocity of the bullet before impact, the percentage loss of kinetic energy because of impact, and the maximum swing, that is theta, of the target. Means after impact, so this object is going to swing. So you have to find out the maximum angle made by that object after impact. Is it clear? So being it is plastic impact, so first we use law of conservation of momentum. What is law of conservation of momentum? M1 U1 plus M2 U2 is equal to M1 plus M2 into V. So being it is plastic impact, V1 is equal to V2. Let us say V. So M1, that is mass of the bullet. We are taking bullet as body 1 and this target is 2. So it is 100 grams. So 0.1. U1 to be found. That is the velocity of bullet before impact. That is to be found. Plus M2 is 10 kg. That object is 10 kg. Into U2. Before impact, it is initially at rest, fired into a freely suspended target of 10 kg. So initially, it is at rest, is equal to 0.1 plus 10 into V, the velocity with which the object and the bullet moving together is given as 7 meters per second. See, the target with bullet moves with a velocity 7 meters per second. So solving this, we get V, that is U1, as 707 meters per second. So this is our first answer. So this is velocity of bullet. Velocity of bullet before impact. Right? Now, to solve the second part, that is percentage loss of kinetic energy. So, this is first part, second part. Percentage loss of kinetic energy is given as the kinetic energy before impact minus kinetic energy after impact upon kinetic energy before impact into 100. So the total kinetic energy of the system before impact minus kinetic energy of the system after impact. So this is the loss of kinetic energy upon the initial kinetic energy, means before impact, into 100. That gives you percentage loss of kinetic energy. Okay. Now, what is the kinetic energy before impact? It is half m1 u1 square plus half m2 u2 square. It's the kinetic energy of the entire system, right? But u2 is 0. So you have 1 by 2 into m1. The mass of the bullet is 0.1 into velocity of the bullet is 707. It is found 707. square. That is equal to 24992.45 joules. So, it is the kinetic energy before impact. Now, we have to find out the kinetic energy after impact. So, after impact, the bullet and the object both are moving together with a velocity 7 meters per second. So, it is half into m is m1 plus m2. Both are moving together, right? Into v square. Both are moving with a common velocity 7 meters per second. So, this gives you 247.45 joules. So, it is the kinetic energy of the system after impact. Therefore, I am rubbing the statement of the problem. The percentage loss of kinetic energy is equal to 24992.45 minus 247.45. That is the loss of kinetic energy upon initial kinetic energy. 24992.45 into 100. So that is around 99%. So there is a 99% loss of kinetic energy because of an impact, right? Now the third point, that is maximum spin. See, after impact, the bullet is inside the block and the block swings. When it reaches the maximum swing, when this the angle theta is maximum, so the velocity of this object will be zero. So initially, after impact, so the velocity of this object is 7 meters per second. So it is given, right? After impact, both are moving this 7 meters per second. And after the maximum swing, the velocity becomes zero. Now, we can use work energy principle from this position to this position, right? So saying this position is 1, where its velocity is 7 meters per second. Say this is position 2, where its velocity is 0. So when it is moving from position 1 to 2, so what is the displacement, vertical displacement? Upwards, right? See, the length of this string is given 3 meters. So we have this angle theta. So this adjacent side, this will be 3 cos theta. Now, the vertical displacement, this h, is equal to total 3 minus 3 cos theta. So, that is 3 into 1 minus cos theta. That is the vertical displacement of this object. Right. Now, using, that is the third part, using work energy principle for the block immediately after impact. So we are using work energy principle immediately after impact from position 1 to 2. So what is work energy principle? Change in kinetic energy is equal to work done. So the final kinetic energy Ke2 minus initial kinetic energy Ke1 is equal to total work done between the positions 1 and 2. So what are the forces doing work on this object when they are moving from position 1 to 2? What are the forces acting? First, the tension in the string. Second, the gravitational force. Right? but work done by the tension in the string is always zero, being it is internal to the system. Right. Now only the gravitational force is doing work. So it is work done by gravity. So I will rub this portion also. Please note down. So the kinetic energy at position 2 is 0, kinetic energy is half mv square, v is 0, minus initial kinetic energy, that is half into m is 10.1, because bullet is inside this block, weight of the bullet is, the mass of the bullet is 0.1 kg and this is 10 kg, so it is 10.1 kg into velocity, here it is 7 square is equal to work done by gravity. So the upward displacement, displacement is upwards, so the work done by gravitational force is negative, minus mgh. Here m is 10.1 into 9.81 into h is 3 into 1 minus cos theta, right? Minus mgh, h is equal to 3 into 1 minus cos theta. So solving this equation, you can get theta as 80.36 degrees. So it is the maximum swing of the object after impact. So when theta is 80.36 degrees, the velocity becomes 0, means the swing is maximum. Understood? Thank you.